Music, songs and music. In concert of a location on a planet, you're going to find people who love music. But now comes one important question. How has it become possible for everyone to access music so easily? The question is simply answered by the fact that is digitalization of musical records that happened recently. If we go a couple of decades back from now, the situation changes completely. And hence, we decided to get down to the roots of some lost technologies in the world of music and explore one of the same, that is gramophone.
Gramophones were mind-blowing in the sense they allowed music or sound to be recorded and listened to. In 1850, with the invention of the first ever phonograph by French inventor Edouard Léon Scott de Martinville, sound recording and playback became radically altered forever. Thomas Edison and Alexander Graham Bell were inspired by him, and their rivalry soon gave birth to the next generation of phonographs whose sound processing machines are today known as gramophones. In the years following the initial release of gramophones, several modifications were made. In 1894, by inventing a method for making flat-shaped discs, Emil Bolliner, an American inventor, gave his gramophone design a name. Gramophone, and the popularity of disc-based sound devices continued to soar. Over the years, the industry adopted many different variations to the physicality of the gramophone, and until the late 1980s, gramophones remained superior to all other media, but eventually were superseded by digital technology.
Now, how exactly does this iconic vintage device work? The main principle behind the old gramophone was the conversion of sound energy to mechanical energy and vice versa. On the contrary, the modern gramophone relies on the conversion of sound energy to mechanical energy, which in turn generates electric signals. But before we get to the working of the gramophone, it is necessary for us to know about the various parts that consist a gramophone and how they function.
A gramophone usually contains the following working parts. To start, you have the sound horn, which acts as a funnel and essentially amplifies vibrations in air, or it could force them into a small point. This allows us to record and also play back the sounds. Then you have the diaphragm, which is a thin membrane, almost like drum skin, and vibrations caused due to sound energy cause this diaphragm to vibrate, which allows us to cut grooves into material like wax. Now, what are these grooves? These are indentations made on material like wax or vinyl by a stylus. The depth of these grooves depend on the kind of sound that's produced. Now, what is the stylus? Well, it's essentially a pin, usually made of hard material like diamond, and it cuts the indentations into the material, which allows us to record and listen to the sounds we want to.
In modern record players, a device known as a cartridge is used. Cartridges are electromagnetic devices that either contain a piezoelectric crystal or an electrical coil and a small magnet in order to convert sound energy into electrical impulses. A stylus is usually fitted onto the cartridge, and every time the stylus wobbles, the cartridge generates an electrical signal. A hand crank. This self-explanatory, it's essentially a handle that is rotated in order to replace a bar and grooves originally etched into the material. Also common in modern devices, but important nonetheless. Turntable. It is a circular revolving plate supporting a record as a display plate. Turntable is also another name for the modern record player, the modern gramophone, which relies on generation of electrical signals. Tuner, the movable part of a phonograph or record player that carries a pickup and permits the needle to follow the record.
The following is a clip from 1942 showing the exact working of an old-timey gramophone. Now let's get back to the technicalities. Let's discuss how exactly does the gramophone work. The horn is attached to the diaphragm of the gramophone. This collects the sound waves which vibrate in air. Moreover, since they can travel down the length of the horn, it allows the diaphragm to vibrate. The stylus is connected to the diaphragm and is pressed against the cylinder covered in wax. Now, on turning the handle, the cylinder rotates, which allows the stylus to cut the grooves. The stylus vibrates accordingly with the sound. Hence, the depth of the grooves is dependent on the loudness of the sound being recorded. After the recording is finished, the wax now contains the recorded sound in the form of grooves.
In order to play back the sound, the process is simply reversed. The stylus, or needle at the time, is placed at the start of the grooves and the handle is cranked. The movement of the needle now causes vibrations, which help translate the grooves back onto the diaphragm. This reaches the horn, which amplifies the sound and the recording is heard back to us. Now, the following is actually a phonograph simulation by Menlo Park Lab.
Mary had a little lamb, its fleece was white as snow. And everywhere that Mary went, the lamb was sure to go.
Now, how does the modern gramophone differ from the phonograph? Well, the basic principle still reflects that of the original phonograph. We still use the same old groove and stylus methodology that was used by the original phonograph. But modern gramophones tend to be a lot more high-tech. For example, modern gramophones employ the use of vinyl records instead of foil or cylinders covered in wax. The stylus is now attached to the tone arm of the record player and it produces vibration as it spins on the turntable. These vibrations that are produced when it traces over the grooves run through a cartridge and this cartridge produces electromagnetic signals. It's these signals that are amplified and is what we hear as music.
To summarize, vinyl record players are electromagnetic devices that convert sound vibrations into electric signals. These are fed into electronic amplifiers and thus the amplified sound is heard. And so with that, farewell.
So long, farewell, I'll be just saying adieu.
Adieu, adieu, to you and you and you.
So long, farewell, oh what I'll be just saying.
I'd like to stay and taste my first champagne. Yes?
No.
So long, farewell, I'll be just saying goodbye.
I leave and heave a sigh and say goodbye.